in circus and in that movement and in those death-defying feats, there are often really clear human stories. So if you're holding someone's hand and you're holding them off a ledge, there is such a trust and a reliance and a bond, and there are so many stories in there. So we use those kind of death-defying and very physical moments as the starting point for stories. So when we made this piece of equipment, initially we actually thought it was going to be a lot more serious and about kind of climbing the social ladder, but it's a very playful piece of equipment, and a lot of times it's about dumping someone on their head, and it's dark as well, but it's funny. So we allowed the sort of death-defying movement to dictate the story so that you're not having to struggle against it, if that makes sense. It's interesting because circus does play with fear. Like, fear's, you know, that's what makes it so compelling. It's the fact that you could fall, and that's the exciting thing about it. But I think it's only exciting to watch when you know that it's dangerous, but you know the person's in control. If you've ever seen an act when someone's not quite in control, it's actually quite unpleasant to watch. It's actually not exciting. It becomes something else. So at this point, having done it for this many years, there's no genuine fear from our side. It's still exciting. You still get a rush of adrenaline, but it's within, well within your bounds by the time you come to perform it. But you have to play that there's fear, because that's the game. In the show, there are four boxes of various sizes, and they sort of represent each person's status. There's a very small box and there's a very large box, and you don't want to be left with the small box in life. And so there's the play between them as they try to gain the upper hand between each other is reflected by who ends up with the big box, who ends up with the small box. It's quite a light piece, but it's a gentle look at the tensions in play between a group of four people and how they get the upper hand. As luck would have it, when there are two people on each rope, we perfectly balance. So it's one of the only times in the show, and it's quite towards the end of the show, where we manage to find an equilibrium, and we manage to do that by creating two couples that at that point are no longer trying to gain the upper hand over each other.